Hardest shot competition, only two guys that have ever won it. That's Al MacInnis shattering some glass in a regular season game. That's how hard MacInnis shoots. He won it in 92 and in 91. He's not going to be competing in the hardest shot, and neither is the man who has won it the other three times with the hardest shot ever in this competition, 105 miles an hour in 1993. This is L.I. Afraidy. How are you?
Good. Haven't seen you in a couple of years.
I wish you were out there on the ice.
Yeah, me too.
Look, we got to ask you that first. Are you going to be able to get back this year?
Yeah, hopefully, yeah. I'm skating now and, you know, progressing, you know, great. My leg's starting to get stronger. You know, obviously, I had some serious damage in my knees, and, you know, I guess playing hurt over all those years kind of added up and hit me all at once. So
we can't wait to have you back.
It's frustrating.
Last night,
the
you
league
took
needs
a shot.
Me.
The league needs you. This is why. This is you. What did you do last night?
I was goofing around with skating and hit a puck and shot 105.
Goofing around. This is a guy who hasn't played for 2 years. He's goofing around. He shoots at 105 miles an hour. L.I. Afraidy, let's take a look here at our competition going on right now. Here's one of your favorites, Chris Chelios.
Yeah, I think he'll win it.
You think he'll win it?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to see. It's a blast measured by the clock. You must get it on net. We'll have the immediate reading for you. You see the record that was set by L.I. Afraidy. That one's at 92. He can't believe it's that low. He qualified at just under 98 miles an hour. Two chances. And they average them out. And the second one also there at 91.7. So 92 and 91.7. Wayne, how come you're not out there?
They didn't want me to go in this competition. I don't know why not.
Al thought you should have been out there. L.I. Afraidy wanted to see you.
Yeah, I'm disappointed they didn't ask me to do this.
Scott Stevens from the New Jersey Devils at 90.1. Scotty qualified at 94.8 for Stevens, his seventh All-Star appearance. The radar gun is how they track this. So 93 will put him on top for the moment. Al, is there any secret in this stuff to get the big shot?
I think it's whatever side you shoot, if you're a left shot, to keep it to the, if you're facing the net, to the right of the net and low.
And low.
If you're a right shot, keep it to the left of the net if you're facing it, and low.
Ed Ward from Calgary qualified at 99 miles an hour. He's only a rookie. And you see what Ed was talking about where he took that shot at 93. Mark Messier good enough to let us wire him up down there. And L.I. Afraidy wanted to know, Mark Messier, how come you're not out there?
They don't allow wrist shots in this competition.
Hey, just goes to show you, Matt, you don't have to shoot it hard to put it in the net, though, right?
Well, I'm a prime example. If it's not how hard, it's just where.
Right.
Al agrees with you on that one. Broken stick, that'll kill you.
How come Mike Modano, he can fire hard.
Each team, of course, went through these skill competitions within the teams to get the qualifiers and didn't make it.
McDonald can really let her fly, too. Are you right about that? He's got a terrific shot.
Peter Bondra broke that stick, rips the second one at 92 miles an hour. Al, nobody's getting close to you.
I think they're trying to make me feel good over there.
They want you back.
Feel bad for me.
Stevens and Ward right now are tied. Scott Stevens took the shot earlier, and Ed Ward. Here's Jason Arnott out of Edmonton. He qualified at 99.2.
Wow, 94 and a half right there. And Jason Arnott, as Al was talking about, he went against the grain, sort of pulling it, and kept it low, got good wood on that one.
Get two chances at it, he ups it again.
Al, I don't know, that surprised me that was so high, because he did get it up high in the net.
Yeah, well, Al MacInnis, when he won it, he always shoots high, and even when he won it, he shot high. I don't know, I think if you skate, I think the faster you're skating, you know, acceleration plus mass equals speed, I think the faster you skate into the puck has something to do with it, too.
Holy cow.
You like that?
John Rolfe. I thought you just drove Harleys. I didn't know you had all that stuff in you.
A renaissance man.
You are a renaissance man. John Rohloff out of Boston, who qualified at 97.
That seemed pretty good.
He had 94 in the first one and 95 on the second.
Let me ask you something, Al. The whippiness of your stick, how stiff were your sticks?
I weigh 230, and my sticks are really stiff, and I think hitting the net, too, because usually when I'm doing this hardest shot competition, my first shot's going to be the hardest, so, it's imperative that you hit the net.
Here's the guy who qualified with the highest L. Dave Manson qualified at over 100 miles an hour. He had 98 on the first one and 97 on the second. So one left to go. It's going to be John LeClair representing the East.
No surprise that Dave Manson shoots that puck hard. I was his teammate for a couple of years, and in practice, I felt that.
You still have some black and blues. John LeClair qualified at 98.3. His first All-Star appearance. Part of that Legion of Doom line in Philadelphia. His second chance here. 94.2. There's Eric Lindros, a member of that Legion of Doom line right there with Philadelphia. So they will do the totals now and see which East or West comes up with a point here. Bill Clements down there with that group of people, Bill.
Yeah, they can total up the team totals, Gary, but the winner of the shot competition, Dave Manson, congratulations. Just the way you had it planned, I imagine.
Yeah, I was just worried about hitting the net, but everything worked out, so I just grip it and rip it the way I play golf.
You were the grip it and rip it. You were the favorite coming into this thing because you qualify with the best time. Did you look at the other lineup and say, look, this is the guy I got to beat?
No, not at all. I just come out here, have a little bit of fun, and like I said, just take a good hard swing at it and bear down.
It works.
Yeah, that's right. It works. And get a little bit more money for the team.
Congratulations.
All right, thanks a lot, Bill.
Guys.
There you see the average speed, the West 94.95, the East 94.50. So the West picking up a goal on that one, and they also pick up the other for the individual winner. So they have a 5-1 lead, the West over the East right now. Coming up, Darren Pang's favorite, goaltenders, going to see some rubber when we come back.